Actress Shweta Menon, with the CPM alleging that the actress was under pressure to retract her statement.
Her decision, but the issues that she raised would still remain, would still continue to haunt Kerala. It was a shock that a chief guest at a function is molested by one of the organizers themselves. There are three points that come out. One, Shweta Menon didn't protest, respond when the incidents occurred. Well, that is a very typical reaction. She doesn't want to disrupt the function, want to keep the decorum and so on. And this is a dilemma that every woman would be facing. Second, and when she chooses to protest later, greatest surprise is a section of the Congress comes out unapologetically about the incident. One, just denying it, despite of all the evidences. Two, maligning her, recalling the type of roles she played in the films or the models she acted, as if that gave them the right to molest her. You see, it is strange to come from Congress leaders.
Pradeep Pillai now joining in for more. There are parties alleging that she has been under political pressure, Pradeep, but some parties actually questioning the timing of this complaint withdrawal. All right, we seem to have lost that line with Pradeep Pillai, but we have been getting reactions on this story. In fact, let's first listen in to Shweta Menon.
There is no pressure whatsoever behind this move. Personally called me and he apologized. I think hum logo ko sikhaya gaya na ki maaf karne ka hai, to bas maine maaf kar diya.
ചെറിയ കാറാക്ഷൻ്റെ ഉണ്ടായ എൻ്റെ ഡിസ്കിന് ഒരു വിഷമം ഉണ്ടായിട്ടുണ്ട് പണ്ട്. അതിനുശേഷം അല്ലെങ്കിൽ എൻ്റെ വലത്തേ കാലിൻ്റെ തള്ളവുള്ള ഞാൻ ചെവി ഓടിയുമായിരുന്നു. അതുകൊണ്ട് ഇങ്ങനെ ഞാൻ ഇങ്ങനെ ഇങ്ങനെയൊക്കെ കാണിക്കും. ഇറ്റ് ഇസ് ടു മച്ച് വേറെ കാര്യമില്ല. അതുകൊണ്ട് എന്നെ ഇങ്ങനെ തീയിട്ടാലും എനിക്ക് വിഷമമില്ല. പക്ഷേ ഇത്രയും ഒന്നും എന്നോട് ചെയ്തുകൂടാം.
Pradeep Pillai back with us on the phone. Pradeep, she might have withdrawn the complaint, but the visual evidence is there for all to see. She was clearly not comfortable with that man around her.
Very much. So she turns around suddenly and gives a sharp look and says "A" to him, which is very clear in the audio also. However, she has now gone on record saying that she is withdrawing all legal and other action following intervention from her family, as well as accepting the apology issued, offered by the MP to her in person as well as in public. However, as you rightly said, the political game is still on. The CPM and left has very clearly said that he will be made to answer for all his deeds. And of course, the legal battle is far from over because the FIR has already been registered. So the political hurdle and the political questions are still remaining for the Congress party and the MP.
There was clearly some muscle flexing that also happened, isn't it? There were protests on ground. Her effigy was being burned. So clearly, the Congress leadership within Kerala did put a lot of pressure on the actress.
Clearly, so there were demonstrations that happened at Kollam, which was organized by the Youth Congress workers. She was burnt in effigy, probably one of the rare occasions when the victim's effigy was burnt. And of course, there was a protest demonstration being organized against the victim. And we also had a report about local Congress leaders trying to malign her by trying to picturize the kind of roles that she has done as an actress and as a model. Well, there was other pressure. There were calls from top-level leaders which went to her and her husband. They definitely do not want to reveal the names or go on record with it, but sources do tell us very clearly that several top leaders of the Congress got in touch with them, tried to plead their cases,
right,
that it will affect the party's image and its electoral prospects. Back